this family is sitting here thinking all we asked you to do was sing. And y'all know the better than that. I was notified that I was going to sing for Jody today. We're singing for the Lord today with his family. And then I was notified what song we're going to sing today. And then I was told that Jody was the one to pick the song. And so I got to thinking about that. And so I came up with two options why Jody picked this song. So option number one, and I don't know if y'all know this about Jody, but he could be a little bit mischievous. mischievous, sneaky. How about that? And so, and he's deciding, okay, I'm gonna get old Keith to sing. What song can I come up with that he is too old to sing now? That's option number one. And through this week, I got thinking about different things and singing this song. And I thought about my grandmother and how after my grandfather passed away, she longed for heaven. And I've heard her say several times, or ask a question, more or less, why has the Lord left me here? She had us, she had friends, she had people checking on her, she had all of that. But she still longed for heaven. And she was tired. And of course, we're all kind of getting tired the more we see how things are going these days. Well, you know what? Jody was tired. I mean, he was really tired. But the key to that is this. He was tired. And I think he'd been dreaming about heaven. I think he'd been longing for heaven. He was tired, but he was not desperate. Because, and I know a lot of people here, but there was no one that believed it any more than Jody Perritt. And he's dreaming about heaven, and he's tired, and he is ready to go. So Jody picked the song. And I want to share that with you this morning.
I dream of a city called glory, so and so fair. As I enter these high-crying glories, the angels all and I bowed on my knees.
Jody is doing today. It's hard for us, but it's not hard for Jody anymore. And I'm so grateful for that. This has been a difficult week. It's been a difficult pill to swallow that Jody is gone. One of my very first memories of Jody having come here as pastor 13 years ago was just seeing this guy on the platform in the choir who was singing, and he was just singing. And he had joy on his face. His face lit up the room. And what an incredible blessing to be Jody and Brenda's pastor. Jody Edward Perritt, 61, of Crossett, passed away on Sunday, November the 6th, 2022, at his home, surrounded by his family. He was born in Garland, Texas on December 11th, 1960, to his parents, David Leon and Alice Sullivan Perritt. He grew up in Gillette, Arkansas, where he helped his dad run their local hardware store and graduated from Gillette High School in 1979. In 1991, Jody moved to Crossett and began a 28-year career with the Arkansas Forestry Commission. He was an active member of First Baptist Church of Crossett, where he enjoyed working with church youth, where he served on the music committee and loved singing in the choir. He was also a member of Phi Lambda Chi Fraternity and the Frost Prairie Fire Department Board. Hunting, vegetable gardening, and of course fishing were among his favorite hobbies. However, his time with his grandchildren, who lovingly called him Poppy, always came first. He is preceded in death by his parents and leaves behind his wife of 30 years, Brenda Turner Perritt of Crossett, two daughters, Jessica Maxwell and husband Brad of Conway, and Hannah Perritt of Crossett, along with four precious grandchildren, Easton and Eli Maxwell, Hunter Pierce and Layla Sellers, and a host of cousins, friends, and other relatives. Father, we come into your presence this morning. Lord, we acknowledge that the paths of life that we have to walk through sometimes just don't make sense to us. And Lord, this path of illness that Jody had been walking for a long time is one of those things. But Father, we come before you this morning just lifting high the name of Jesus and thanking you for the gift of life that you've given to us and the gift of life that Jody experienced as he walked with you these many years. And Father, we realize today that Jody is no longer suffering, but that his family and his friends who are gathered here today are going to struggle in the days to come. Lord, as we all walk through the process of grieving the loss of Jody, we pray your special watch care over each person. And Father, I pray especially for those in Jody's life who have never committed their lives to Jesus Christ, that Jody's life would speak of the truth of who Jesus is and what Jesus did for him. And Lord, would bring assurance into their hearts that Jody no longer is suffering, but is experiencing full and abundant life in Jesus in heaven today. Lord, we love you. We thank you for that. And Father, we pray that you would guide us through the remainder of our time together today, that we would bring honor and glory to you in everything that we do. We love you, Lord, and we pray these things in the matchless name of our Savior Jesus. Amen.
Thank you.
trumpet played in this room again, isn't it? Amen. Jody would have loved that, Brother Greg. Thank you for making the trip from Alabama to be here today to play for Jody's funeral service. Keith, thank you for singing. What an incredible blessing you both have been to us today. This morning, we grieve and we mourn. But Scripture tells us in 1 Thessalonians 4:13, we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers, concerning those who are asleep, so that you'll not grieve like the rest who have no hope. Jody knew the promise of God and had given his heart to Jesus Christ many years ago. And as a result, with the same hearts that are burdened with grief today, we also have the freedom and the opportunity to celebrate knowing where Jody is today. So we give God praise and thanks for that. As we remember and say goodbye to Jody this morning, there are some things that I'd like to share with you that I pray are words of encouragement to you from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 6 through 8. The Apostle Paul says, "For I'm already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time for my departure is close. I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. There is reserved for me in the future the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day. And not only to me, but to all those who loved his appearing." I read the Apostle Paul's words here, and I think about Jody's life, and I think about the last days of Jody's life, the last years, really, of Jody's life, that were marked by struggle and hardship. But do you know, every time I saw Jody, he had a smile on his face. He was always smiling. He was always in a different attitude, a different frame of mind than what some of us would expect someone in Jody's situation to be in, because he had a relationship with the Lord. Because he knew that whenever this life ended, it wasn't the end of life for him, but it was really the beginning of the real experience of life. And what the Apostle Paul says here brings some encouragement to us. And as we think about, as we think about Jody's life, let me share with you what I think three words of encouragement about Jody's life that we can draw from his life and from what the Apostle Paul says here. First of all, Jody recognized the season. Paul says in verse 6, "For I'm already being poured out as a drink offering, and the time for my departure is close." You know what Paul's saying? Paul's saying to his son in the ministry, Timothy, that he knows that the end of his life is coming. He knows that his days are numbered. He knows that there aren't going to be very many more opportunities to pour into his son in the ministry. And so he leaves him with these final words, and these words and following that are words of truth for Timothy to cling on to. And part of that truth that Timothy is to cling on to is the fact that Paul recognized the season. The Apostle Paul wrote these words knowing that the end of his life was going to come. And in a similar way, Jody knew that this life was coming to an end. And I want you to know this morning that he was ready to go home to be with the Lord. He was ready. We go through different seasons in life, don't we? We go through good seasons. We go through difficult seasons. We go through storms in life. We go through hardship and struggle. We go through moments that are characterized by joy and hope, and others that are characterized by sadness and sorrow. And this has been a difficult season for this family. But Jody knew that to be absent in the body, from the body, is to be present with the Lord. And Jody not only had the ability to recognize the season in his own life, but he also had the ability to recognize the season in other people's lives. We had the privilege, our choir, and they let me tag along with them a couple of weeks ago. We drove out to Jody and Brenda's house, and Jessica and Brian were there, and the choir sang three of Jody's favorite numbers from his time in the choir. And it was one of the sweetest, one of the most precious moments that I've ever experienced in ministry. I've been a pastor now for 22 years, been in ministry for 30 years, Brenda. And that was one of the sweetest moments I've ever experienced, just to be able to be there with your family. And to see Jody's face light up as he sang those songs like he always did when he stood up here in the choir loft. What an incredible blessing. And before we spent some time praying over Brenda and Jody, Jody said, "Preacher, before we pray, let me just share something with you." And he shared with us how earlier in that week had been a very difficult day, a very difficult night. And the next morning he woke up and he told Brenda, he said, "We got to get our grandkids here. I got to talk to them and make sure that they know who Jesus is." And so Jody had that conversation with his grandkids not long before he passed away, just a couple of weeks before he passed away. You see, Jody didn't just recognize the season in his own life. He also recognized the season in other people's lives as well. He was a man of faith, and he lived his life with the Lord. Was Jody perfect? Nope. None of us is. And so we don't come into this moment trying to glorify Jody, but we come into this moment to honor a life that was well lived and to glorify Jesus Christ for what he did in giving Jody the hope of eternal life. And I think that if Jody were able to communicate with you and I today, I wonder if one of the questions he might ask would be, what season of life do you find yourself in? Are you going through a difficult season? Are you going through a season of happiness and joy? Cherish those seasons if you are, because it seems like in life they're few and far between. But you see, Jody didn't just recognize the season, whether it was a season of happiness or sadness or difficulty or struggle. You see, Jody lived his life with joy. Joy is different than happiness. Joy is independent of the circumstances of our lives, while happiness is dependent upon the circumstances of our lives. And the joy that he had was found in his relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. And maybe the Lord has you here today to be encouraged by Jody's life. Jody had no fear of what was to come when he breathed his final breath. Had no fear at all. You might ask, well, how could he have had no fear in his life? It's because he was prepared for eternity. Before that visit that we had with the choir a couple of weeks ago, I had the opportunity to visit with Jody a couple of weeks before that. And in that conversation, Jody shared with me about how he walked the aisle when he was a child. And told his church and told his family that he was giving his life to Jesus Christ. But he realized sometime later that the only reason he went down was because his best friend also went down that Sunday. And he had never really genuinely given his heart to Jesus. And so sometime later, Jody shared with me that he had given his life truly, authentically, genuinely to the Lord Jesus Christ. When Jody became a follower of Jesus, he made preparation for eternity. Are you prepared for eternity? Jody recognized the season. Let me share with you a second thought from this passage and from Jody's life. And you'll agree with this without a doubt. Jody endured the struggle. Listen to what verse 7 says. Paul says, "I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith." Many of us who have spent any time in church have memorized this verse of scripture because of what Paul says here. I've fought the good fight. I've kept the faith. I've finished the race. But life is filled with struggle, isn't it? I mean, life is hard. We have a tendency to look through rose-colored lenses when we're young, and as we begin to experience a little bit more of the realities of life, those rose-colored lenses begin to fade away, and we begin to see how life really is and what it really is. And it is hard. Struggle is just a part of life. Someone has wisely observed that you're either preparing to enter a storm, or you're in the midst of a storm, or you're exiting a storm in your life. That's just how life is. And Paul is admonishing Timothy here in verse 7 through his own life and the example that struggling through those storms is worth it. He just told Timothy in verse 5 to fulfill your ministry. He's telling Timothy in his final words, listen, don't give up. Keep fighting the fight. Keep running the race. Don't give up. Fulfill your ministry, knowing that in fulfilling his ministry, the cost will be high. But think about the language that he uses in verse 7. He says, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Fighting the good fight is preceded by training, and training is hard. It's not easy. Endurance comes before finishing the race, and endurance is a challenge. And keeping the faith requires perseverance, and persevering is difficult. But I want you to know that training and endurance and perseverance characterize the life of Jody Perritt. Royce Gladden met me in the sanctuary a few Sundays ago and told me that he had been out to see Jody the day before, and that Jody asked him to ask me to come out and see him that afternoon. He had something that he needed to talk to me about. And so almost immediately after I arrived, Jody said to me, Preacher, I need to ask you a question, and I don't really know how to ask it, but I'm just going to ask it. I said, okay, go ahead, Jody. What's your question? He said, what if I'm too tired to keep fighting this? He said, what if I'm too tired to keep going on? And I told him, Jody, it's okay if you're too tired. It's okay for you to go be with Jesus. He followed that up with, I just don't want anybody to think that I quit, that I gave up. And I said, Jody, there's not a person who knows you that's going to think that you quit or that you gave up. Man, we have watched you battle. And we have watched you fight this valiantly for years. Nobody is going to think that you just quit. See, for Jody, that perseverance and endurance was not something to be trifled with, but was serious. And he wanted you to know that he didn't just give up. Through it all, he earnestly contended for the faith. And if he were here today, I'm certain he'd ask you, are you contending for the faith? Are you fighting the good fight? Let me share with you one final word of encouragement that is really the greatest word of encouragement that we find here in this text from the Apostle Paul. And it's that Jody realized the reward. And the reward wasn't based on monetary gain. It wasn't based on things, accolades that he could receive in life. But listen to what the Apostle Paul says in verse 8. He says, there is reserved for me in the future the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not only to me, but to all those who have loved his appearing. There is laid up for me a crown of righteousness. This is the reason that Jody had no fear in dying. He understood that his eternal reward was heaven. And he understood that that eternal reward meant just what Keith's saying about, that he would bow on his knees and cry holy and worship Jesus for all of eternity. Let me just share with you one final thing that I think Jody would say to you if he was able to have one more conversation with you. I think that as much as Jody loved gardening, as much as he loved fishing, as much as he loved his grandchildren, his family, I think that having experienced the riches of heaven, the presence of Jesus, the one thing that Jody would want to talk to you about is whether or not you're prepared for eternity. Because that's the only thing that really matters. Are you prepared for eternity? There's only one way to be prepared for eternity, and that's to trust in Jesus Christ as your Savior. and to walk with him throughout the remaining days of her life. That's what Jody did. And we come today and are able to celebrate a life that was well lived, a life that endured the struggle, a life that realized the reward. And I can think of no better tribute to Jody's life than for someone among his friends and family who had never given his or her heart to Jesus to come to know Christ as Savior through the process of saying goodbye to Jody. That's what Jody wanted. You know, last thing, the very last thing that Jody said to me was, I was at his house last, I was at their house last Wednesday, I guess it was. And he said, "Preacher, I want you to preach hell or high water. Let them know that they need Jesus. And I want you to know if you don't have Christ in your heart, you need Jesus. So that you can have the hope of eternity like Jody had." It's pretty simple. You just recognize that you're a sinner. If you acknowledge that there's something, that one thing that you've done in your life that's not right and not good, then you acknowledge that you're a sinner and that you need help. And that help comes only in and through the person of Jesus Christ. Would you give your heart to him today? That's what Jody would want. Father, we come before you this afternoon, this morning. Lord, we are so grateful for your love for us, for the provision of life that you've given to us. Lord, I woke up this morning thinking about this day and thinking about saying goodbye to Jody. And the first thing that came to my mind was, Lord, your mercies are renewed to us this morning. Great is your faithfulness. Lord, thank you for a life that was well lived. Thank you, Father, for the promise that those of us who were followers of Jesus were going to see Jody again. And when we see him again, he's not going to be missing any legs. He's not going to be missing a finger. Lord, he's going to be who you intended him to be and what you intended him to be for all of eternity. God, we give you thanks. We realize that the only way that that's possible is through the sacrifice of your son Jesus on the cross for Jody's sin. And Lord, you did that for all of us. I pray that if there's one person here who's not ready for eternity, Father, that Jody's life would speak into that life and say, come to faith in Jesus. Lord, I love you, and I'm grateful for your love for me. And I pray these things in the matchless name of our Savior Jesus.